Warning, the following video is rated D for degenerate. Viewer discretion is advised.
Hey guys, it's Derich here, and I wanted to apologize to Reese Robbins. I'm extremely sorry.
I'm gonna give you all a big recommendation. You ready for this? Leave Derek's name out of your fucking mouth. Derek's not here. He's not affecting anyone in a negative way. Shut the fuck up.
Derich guy, like, pissed me off a little bit.
Why do you mispronounce Derek's name? Because that's how I thought it was pronounced, and I called it that for years and years and years with Derek. He actually told me later it's actually Derish.
Problem, Stella. You guys both deserve the mods, because I need them as a band of trolls.
TSM, 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 TSM.
Video was supposed to be an update, a DLC from my previous video, where I was going to talk about some of the new dent heads that popped up, and some of the drama surrounding the dents, like the whole Jinx OIC Ryan debacle, where this guy gave Phil $3,000 in the span of 2 weeks, and his reward for that was getting doxxed.
So Jinx tipped me $100 again. Again,
I was going to talk about one of the most pathetic people within DSP's community, Jax Raxer, who gave Phil $1,000 for simply booting up Street Fighter VI. And we were going to dive a little deeper into the King Degenerate's online activity. However, upon doing my research, I came to a realization. Derek, he's a star. He doesn't need any co-stars. He deserves his very own video. So, with all that being said, get your liquor, get your weed, get whatever the fuck you need, and you're gonna need it for this video, as we explore the depraved world of Derek IP.
TSM, TSM.
Derek has been following DSP essentially since he's been allowed to be on the internet. I'm talking like 2015, 2016-ish. And he looks at Phil almost like a role model or a personal hero, and will go to great lengths to try to get in touch with him or have him respond to him, whether it's spamming the same nonsensical message in his chat ad nauseum until Phil acknowledges what he says, or tagging him in multiple different tweets a day on some Notice Me Senpai shit. He even went as far as to stealing his mother's credit card to give Phil money so he could acknowledge what he's saying to him. However, once Derek's mother found out about it, she shut that shit down in a heartbeat. But that didn't stop him. He would go on to harass DSP's viewers in the live chat to send him a cheer with his message in it.
Okay, shout out to Sadella, who cheered and said, Derek loves Lemur, says the San Diego Comic-Con is also filled with cosplayers and is a sad Johnny Gargano's NXT career is over and screw Ciampa.
He even tried to follow in his hero's footsteps and become a content creator. He started doing live streams on Twitch and uploading videos to YouTube with innovative ideas like asking wrestlers questions or flexing his bicep while singing the Pokemon theme song.
I will travel across the web, searching far and wide. People want to understand the power that's inside Pokemon. I know it's my destiny. Pokemon, yeah, you're the best friend in the world we must defend. Pokemon.
For some odd reason, though, that didn't work out for him. I have no idea why. He's a creative genius. But if this is all there was to Derek, I probably wouldn't even be making this video. I mean, yeah, he's a dent head and says and does goofy shit on the internet, but if this was all there was to it, it's not that entertaining or interesting. However, there is one thing about Derek that I did leave out, and that's the fact he is a massive coomer.
Holy fuck, I'm coming. Lois.
Whenever Derek is on the internet, he's on there specifically to vigorously beat his dick like a redheaded stepchild. And how do we know this disturbingly? Well, it's because whenever he's done watching one of these adult films, he'll go to Twitter and tag all the adult film stars that were in the video he watched and let them know just how much of a good job they did and how much he appreciated that video. And he's got cooming on his mind so frequently that he's even accidentally typed one of his searches into DSP's chat.
Okay. So indeed, guys, we are halfway through the show. I would like to stand up and stretch a little bit because we're not taking a formal break, but I'd like to just stand up and stretch my legs a little bit, and then we'll continue on. Again, guys, thank you for being here. If you could support the channel today, it would be great. Super chats, memberships, gifted memberships would be superb right now if you wanted to support the show and the channel. But let me stretch. Oh, man. Ooh.
There's a reason why when you go to his Twitter page, you're met with a sensitive content warning. Because all he talks about on there is cooming and tweeting at adult film stars. And it's not one or two tweets a day, as weird as that is in and of itself. No, 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 no. According to his Twitter analytics, he averages 40 tweets a day, with the overwhelming majority of those being at these adult film stars, with the occasional DSP and wrestling tweets sprinkled into the mix. He essentially harasses these women on Twitter all fucking day until they give him the interaction that he's so desperate and thirsty for. A great example of this was when somebody posed as Reese Robbins' manager, a porn star that he was harassing on Twitter, and they told him that they didn't appreciate him harassing her and that he needed to make an apology video to Reese, which he actually did.
Hey guys, it's Derich here, and I wanted to apologize to Reese Robbins. I'm extremely sorry, and I wanted to tell Reese that she will always be one of my many favorite porn stars to watch.
And no adult film star is safe, because he's into virtually everything from midgets, trans, puke, piss, and other forms of scat, and even clown porn, which I didn't even know was a thing, so thanks for scarring me for life, Derich. But it seems like he's moved away from harassing adult film stars on Twitter, and is now harassing cam girls, specifically on the website Cherry Pimps, where he's using a broken link to gain access to these streams and bypassing the paywall, because he doesn't have mommy's credit card. And if you think what he says on Twitter is degenerate, wait till you see what he says in these girls' live chat.
Years start coming and they don't stop 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 coming and they don't stop.
One of my personal favorites is when he tells these whores how to properly pronounce his name. See, it's not Derich with a K. It's Derish with an H. And if they mispronounce his name, he's going to spam the same message over and over again in their chat, letting them know how to properly pronounce his name until they say his name correctly.
Derich, thank you so much for the follow. Oh, here we go. Oh, sorry. Derish. Rich.
And if they don't say his name correctly or just completely ignore him outright, well, Derich gets very, very angry.
Tell me why I'm stuck as a virgin with rage.
Another one of my favorites is his use of DSP-isms when interacting with these whores. See, when these girls are done performing in one of their live streams, he'll tell them, wow, you've earned a well-deserved water break. Sound good?
Sound good.
Sound good?
Alright, that's... sounds good to me.
Like, he idolizes DSP so much to the point where he's incorporated his mannerisms into his own vocabulary. But still, none of these compare to my favorite thing he does with these women. And it's when he tells them what he thinks their pussies taste like. From everything from mango ice cream to cotton candy and Trader Joe's tacos.
What? What the fuck?
Eventually, his antics would start having people get completely fed up with him. And it's not just the detractors. These cam girls and the women he was harassing on Twitter have had enough of him, with one of them even calling him out directly.
I'm fine. That Derich guy, like, pissed me off a little bit. I was talking to him, but, like, at a certain fucking point when you ask me, you got that? Like, bro, I'm fucking responding to the people that are tipping. Like, have some respect for them.
And the trolling started to ramp up. A lot of people started to pile on and start fucking with Derich, with One of the best of them being a channel by the name of The Marked One, who used the same broken link that Derek was using to gain access to the these live girls' chat. And I believe he either brought his buddies in or he posted it somewhere to have other people come hop in. And they came up with some ingenious names and just spammed his comments out of their live chat. But words don't give it justice. Let's just roll the clips.
Just spam his message off the screen. Get his messages off the screen. Get his links out of there. Get Derek's shit out of there.
You're just like whacking off in a fur coat. That's next level.
She's like, you're whacking off in a fur coat.
We're gonna have some fun today, guys.
I got a fur coat on. I got a fur coat on. Can you say Derek can replace the H with a K, please? You lads are killing him. You're killing him right there. You're absolutely killing him. Look, he's spamming hard. Bro, look how hard he's spamming. Look how hard he's spamming, bro. He's spamming so hard. He's going so hard already. He's spamming so hard already. It was like five in a row right there. Cat Burnell, my husband is reacting to this. Bro, he's spamming so hard. He's absolutely... Can you mark one with an H? Bro, don't at me. You copied my name.
Whoever made that Cat Burnell profile, cheers to you, because that was fucking hilarious. But the trolling ended up bleeding over into DSP's own chat, because believe it or not, even DSP's live viewers are sick and tired of Derek. And it started off with both detractors and his actual viewers spamming cherry emotes in DSP's chat to make fun of Derek because of the website Cherry Pimps. And of course, DSP has to shut it down and protect his favorite fan.
All right, I'm just being honest. Also, I already see people misbehaving in the chat. I'm going to give you about 20 seconds to stop spamming emotes. Because if you don't stop spamming in 20 seconds, I'm just going to start laying out bans. Because I just have no tolerance for it anymore. Really, like, I just don't. All right? We're going to have a good chill week here with gameplay and fun. We're not going to have people acting like children. All right? I'm done with it. I'm not going to have people derailing my stuff. People already complained about that before I went on break earlier this week, saying, I don't know why people are doing this. It's derailing the chat. So, that's it. The next person that I see doing it gets a ban, and then we'll just continue on with that. It's that simple. All right. Okay, had done a bunch of super chats here. One joking about stealing his mother's credit card, which isn't funny, by the way. You shouldn't make jokes like that. Ina re-upped his membership for 5 months and says the cherry emote seems harmless. It is not. I'm just telling you, it's a disgusting meme, and it should not be used. And if it's used, you will be banned, and I'm saying it outright. No other justification is required. There's your answer.
I know that there are differing opinions on this topic, but I'm of the personal belief that you should never, under any circumstance, give Phil money. Even if it's for a troll super chat making fun of Derek stealing his mother's credit card to give Phil money, you should never do that. I mean, he barely even acknowledged it. You might as well have taken that money and thrown it into a fire, and you would have got the same exact value out of it. But secondly, DSP, you're saying that you know what this meme is in reference to, so you know that this is a meme making fun of Derek harassing camgirls, and yet you're banning people using that emo and said, oh, it's a disgusting meme. Like, yeah, it's disgusting because one of your favorite fucking super fans is harassing women online and you just turn a blind eye to it. But this was just a small taste, because after the Trader Joe's Tacos comment came out, people started to flood DSP's chat with the spamming a taco emo and sending him messages in reference to Trader Joe's Tacos. And Phil went full white knight for Derek.
Suede became a member for a month. Can you try Trader Joe's Tacos for summer event? Again, what do you mean? What are Trader Joe's Tacos? Are you saying that there's like a frozen taco or something in there you can make at home? No, if I were going to do it, my wife's going to make stuff. My wife is actually going to make fresh stuff. There's no reason to get like a frozen thing from Trader Joe's when she's going to make fresh recipes. Okay, I got to ask, who's recommending Trader Joe's frozen tacos? Who is it? Oh, really? This taco thing makes fun of Derek now? You guys are fucking losers. I mean, can I say this officially? If you make fun of any stream chatter, Derek or otherwise, you're a fucking loser.
Oh, really? We're the losers, DSP. Okay. I can't wait to hear this explanation.
What is your life? You sit on a streamer's stream, you pick on someone who's in the chat? Like, how low can you be? Like, look at your own fucking life, you fucking loser. You're gonna sit there and make fun of someone online who you don't know, doesn't do anything to hurt you, just because it makes you feel better about yourself.
Phil, people go into your chat to fuck with Derek because they know he's going to be there. And they know that when they send their troll messages, Derek is going to see them. And as far as us not knowing him in real life, yeah, that may be true. We may not know him in real life, but we know him based off of what he posts on the internet to get a good idea of what kind of person he is. And yes, making fun of this dipshit does make me feel good about myself. It brings me a lot of laughs. But one thing that perplexes me is when you said that, oh, he doesn't harm you. How do you know that one of the people that is in there bitching about Derek isn't one of the girls on the internet that he's been harassing?
Right? You're the loser. You're way worse than anything that these people have ever done on the internet if all you do is sit around trying to make fun of them and bring them down. Like, what the fuck is your problem?
DSP, you're gonna regret saying that later on in this video.
You're gross people. Really, every one of you who would make fun of someone like that, you're a disgusting individual, and you really should spruce it up. Take a look at yourself in the mirror and realize you're no fucking amazing paragon of existence on this planet either. You also have flaws. Maybe you should work on yourself and stop worrying about everyone else.
Phil, none of us are claiming to be perfect people. We are saying, though, that we are better people than Derek, because Derek is a deranged sex addict that's going to inevitably end up on a watch list. And yet, we're the disgusting ones, not the guy jerking off 18 hours a day and harassing girls on the internet because they don't say his name properly. No, no, we're the disgusting ones. What kind of fucking logic is that?
How about this? I'm gonna give you all a big recommendation. You ready for this? Leave Derek's name out of your fucking mouth.
Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth!
Derek's not here. He's not affecting anyone in a negative way. Shut the fuck up. If I see you talking about him, I'm just gonna fucking cock slap you with an assy-coat penis off the stream forever. Cause I'm tired of hearing it. I really am. Like, how much of a loser can you fucking be? Shut the fuck up about him.
That entire clip is just oozing with irony, from him talking about smacking you with a penis in defense of Derek, and him saying for us to keep Derek's name out of our mouths when in fact all Derek wants is for people to say his name. But Phil, you say that he's not affecting anyone in a negative way. What about the women and adult film stars that he harasses on a daily basis? Do you not think that he's affecting them in a negative way?
No one cares. You're obsessed. You're the weirdo obsessed with this one chatter. Not me. Not normal people. You weirdos out there, shut the fuck up about Derek and stop harassing him, or I'm going to get you off my stream forever, and I'm not going to feel too bad about it either. In fact, when you ask for the unban, I'm going to write you a special email that says, ha ha ha, you fucking idiot. Maybe you should have acted like a fucking respectable human and not harass people.
Oh yeah, we're the weirdos because we troll and make fun of Derek. But Derek, he's a completely normal person. It's completely normal to beat your dick for 18 hours a day, consistently spam tweet at adult film stars until they interact with you, and beg cam girls to read your messages. Yeah, Phil, that's completely normal behavior. But that little email bit that you did right there, instead of directing that at us, why don't you direct that at your sex pest and tell him to stop harassing cam girls?
All right, Emir, enjoy your lifetime ban. You're not coming back. You just started harassing him, Derek again. Go fuck yourself. Okay. Chad Michael Furry re-upped their membership, says, oh, it's an asshole. Chad Michael Furry, fuck you. You're now banned too. Like, you guys are real fucked up, right?
I'll always be of the opinion that content creators are not responsible for their viewers' actions. However, in this particular scenario, it gets a little bit tricky. And it has nothing to do with the fact that I dislike DSP. It's the fact that Phil has publicly came out time and time and time again defending Derek and ignoring any of the criticism or evidence levied towards Derek. And when he inevitably does harm somebody, DSP, you better not memory hole it. You better come out and publicly disavow Derek and be like, wow, I didn't know he was that kind of fucked up piece of shit. Now, There is one thing regarding Derich that I haven't discussed yet because I wanted to save it for last. Because, in my opinion, it's the most disturbing thing surrounding him. And it's the fact that Derich...
I love little girls, they make me feel so good. I love little girls, they make me feel so bad.
After the discovery of Derek's YouTube channel, people ended up going over to his created playlist, and at first glance, nothing was out of the ordinary. You had your stereotypical gameplay videos, your DSP videos, and some wrestling videos in there. But after taking a second look at them, it was discovered that Derich had multiple disturbing playlists on his channel, and with even more disturbing names for these playlists. See, Derich had saved hundreds of videos of little girls, one of these playlists just being titled Little Girls with a singular video in it. But it gets worse. There was child YouTubers that he saved over 200 of their videos and created a playlist out of it. And then we can't forget about the Little Girls Pretty playlist he had with 174 videos into it. But the worst of them is Beautiful Little Girls with a Smiley Face with 300 videos saved to them. Derich, there is no excuse for you to have these girls' videos saved to your channel, let alone with these titles for these playlists. I'm not calling you a pedophile, but this is raising some massive red flags. And when confronted with this, Derich said, "Oh, guys, I just thought the videos were fun and cute videos. You know, I had no ill intentions with them, but I understand why you people think that this is disturbing and wrong, so I deleted them. I understand that this was wrong." Oh, do you really, Derich? Well, why was it then discovered about a month ago that you're following multiple young girls on your Instagram account? Specifically, young Asian girls and child models. And you're even trying to interact with these young girls and get into conversations with them on Instagram. There is no fucking excuse for this, Derich. This is some sick, disgusting behavior. And normally, I would provide the screenshots of these profiles to further prove my point and provide the evidence. However, given the ages of these girls, I don't feel comfortable putting their profile pictures in this video, even if I censor them out. It just rubs me the wrong way. But this entire thing is giving me flashbacks, as if the past is repeating itself. I mean, here we have a massive DSP fan that's a sexual degenerate and likes to look up videos of young girls on the internet. Where have I seen this before?
Dude, looking up kids in the bathtub isn't fucking pedophilia. The only reason why it's pedophilia if you jerk off to it. I didn't even jerk off to it at all.
That's where I heard this before. Derich, you are paving the way to become the next bathtub boy. And Phil, you remember earlier in the video when you said this?
Right? You're the loser. You're way worse than anything that these people have ever done on the internet if all you do is sit around trying to make fun of them and bring them down. Like, what the fuck is your problem?
Yeah. You may want to walk that one back, given what we now know about your favorite superfan. Now, Derich was inevitably banned from Cherry Pimps after the owner of the website had a nuclear meltdown about him. And even more titty streamers started calling him out on stream after hearing about his YouTube playlists.
So, like, girls and stuff, he was always on my Twitter being like, "Oh, I love how much you do this and this. I hope you collab with this and this." And then he had a YouTube playlist full of, like, playlists called, like, Cute Little Girls. Yeah, like, 20 playlists of just, like, kids on their YouTubes.
That's creepy.
Yeah. A thousand people are watching him.
In conclusion, folks, Derich, you're a piece of shit, but you really need to seek some therapy or something because you are one disturbed individual, and I do not want to find out about you harming somebody, in particular a child. You need to seek some form of help, dude. Seriously. And Phil, you need to distance yourself from this man. And this is genuine advice. You really need to put some distance between you and Derich, because when he inevitably harms somebody, hopefully not a child, people are going to give you massive amounts of shit for it. And knowing you, because you're a piece of shit, you're just going to memory hole it and pretend like you had no idea what was going on. But with all that being said, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, drop me a like, maybe a sub, maybe a share, or a comment. If you're Derich, a DSP fan, or DSP himself, or a supporter of your local NAMBLA chapter, go ahead and hit that dislike button, you pieces of fucking shit. Just make sure, though, that you all participate. And I'll see you all in the next video. But until then, I'm Monster. Peace. The fuck.